proceeding towards panel discussion. The session will be chaired by Dr. Rajesh Singh sir, University Librarian and Head of Delhi University Library System. It gives me great pleasure to say something about Dr. Rajesh Singh sir, a distinguished figure in the field of library and information science. Having completed his BLIC and MLIC from Banaras Hindu University, followed by an MPhil from Annamalai University and a PhD from University of Delhi, Dr. Rajesh Singh sir's academic credentials are truly impressive. Currently serving as the university librarian at the prestigious University of Delhi, his involvement in numerous academic and administrative affairs, including his role in the university core committee for centenary celebrations, reflects his dedication to advancing the university's mission and vision. In recognition of his outstanding contribution to the field of librarianship, Dr. Singh sir was awarded the prestigious ILA Gidwani Deshpande Best Academic Librarian Award in 2019. His dedication to excellence, coupled with his extensive experience and scholarly achievements, make him a highly respected figure in the academic community. Now, let us proceed with the panel discussion under the esteemed chairmanship of Dr. Rajesh Singh sir. Sir, over to you.
Thank you, Gyan Priti. I wish you all the luck and you are a good presenter. Your terms which you have used are wonderful. I don't know whether I deserve those terms or not. Okay, moving ahead, friends. The last session ended with a note that there are requirements. So this session starts with the same note. What are the requirements of standards for library and information activities? Part of the panel from the last session, we three are already here. The rest of the persons I'm inviting, Dr. Garima Sharma, please join the panel. Dr. Prashant Arve, sir, please join the panel. Dr. Shiva, please join the panel. And we are lucky to have a researcher among us who is researching on the standards in libraries. Still, you are not Dr. Naresh? Okay. So, Mr. Naresh Kumar, please join. So, friends.
Should I start?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, we have, I think, shortage of time also, but I want really to make this panel discussion fruitful. I am not going in detail of introducing each other. I request the panelists to briefly introduce themselves, their name and what they are doing along with their designation. But before we start, I request few of my colleagues to facilitate the persons who are new to the panel. I request Monica Gupta, please join us to facilitate Dr. Siva Kanojia. Next is Dr. Vinod Kumar. Please, you also join us.
Bhim, please join us. Dr. Bhim, you could come next. Dr. Mantri to Garima.
So I briefly introduce the topic and then I request the panelists to please be concise. We have 5 minutes time for each of the panelists. To my understanding, standards for all the library operations and activities are required as a precise guidelines, right? And later on, once the activity is completed or the operation is completed, for peace of mind, so that you are comfortable that we have done the right thing. To my mind, there are guidelines which have already been presented by different speakers earlier, but we are now in new information environment, right? So the guidelines for the comfortable chairs and tables for the library users, they need to be revamped. They need to be rediscussed and redesigned, because this new information environment requires a different kind of setup where they can read with a laptop and they where they can use the electronic resources as well. So to my understanding, we need new guidelines, new standards in terms of infrastructure, in terms of sections and strengths of the sections according to the strength of the users which library is supposed to provide services, library operations, reports and statistics. Believe me, they are the only tool in the hands of librarian through which you can prove that whatever investment or whatever activity you are carrying is fruitful, and then certain guidelines which are required, for example, for electronic resources, subscription as well as purchase. So now this panel discussion is open. I would like to invite Dr. Naresh first, because I believe you are the junior most, Naresh. You have a student. And Naresh, why I am inviting Naresh, because he is working, he is doing research on this topic. So Naresh, over to you. You can use that mic, please. 5 minutes.
Good evening, everyone. I am Naresh Kumar, a research scholar from Department of Library Information Science, University of Delhi. And I am doing my PhD under Professor Madhusudan Magam. And in the year 2020, I come across BIS. I saw a website. And then I have to do PhD. So we thought to have a topic which is quite practical. In sense, we can get something out of it. So, I am doing a lot of research, and you know, as a researcher, we used to make references, bibliographies. We do cite different sources. There are different sources available. There are different citations styles available for all of us, APA, MLA, and likewise. And they have automatic citation tools for them. Reference management managers are there. But when I saw that there are Indian standard available, Indian bibliographic reference style is available, and that has been adopted by ISO, Indian International Standards Organization, and I go through that whole document, and I found that it has not been known to anyone. I mean, at least to me, I have never heard of this sort of citation style. So I thought I'll make efforts to automate it, make it automatic, so that people will come across it and will use it instead of all those foreign reference styles. So I took IS 2381 2014. It's Indian Standards Information and Documentation Bibliographic References, IES IDBR. So I gone through it, and I found a lot of things which we can revise in this. So we approach you for further revision for this. Presently, I have designed an automatic Indian citation generation tool. It's in process, but half of it has been done. And you might have seen that Zotero, Mendeley, EndNote, those have the option to choose MLA style or APA style, but they do not have option for this Indian standard, so that people can use it. But we will make our hard efforts to make it there. So that's my target, sir. Yes, okay. Further to for this study, we have made a comparative study of MLA, APA, and this standard, that how much different it is, whether it can be a standard which can be used to all researchers from all different fields. Why it has not been used? What are the reasons? We come across different reasons, and one of them was it is not automatic. It is not, you know, awareness is not there. It has not been marketed. So we will try to do it. So that we can assure. Then further, I can say I am assistant librarian from Central Institute of Haryana since last 7 years. And to this audience, I would say we have a lot of scope in this field, in standards field, because AI is just side of us, artificial intelligence. We can automate most of the you know, these standards in different ways. It's a very open, wide field. That's it.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dinesh. We came across in 2009 when the first ICAL was organized at University of Delhi. And since then, Naresh has grown and grown a lot. I'm really satisfied with your growth, Naresh. Now I request Dr. Siva Shukla Kanojia, please. Yeah, one by one. Your viewpoint, please.
Thank you, sir. While we are thinking about how to adopt Indian standards, or we should be revising international standards for our own libraries, or we should be implementing them as it is, as per the policies or the rules or regulations, so first of all, we should be thinking about what may be the major points for consideration. The first point is that the user needs. For all kind of implementation of standards across the world, in different countries, the first consideration is about the user's needs. One should be aware of what kind of user needs are there. The second point comes there, the collection development. We should be according to some system. A systematized collection development is very much need of the hour. Instead of going for bulk purchase or subscriptions, we should think about what kind of research needs are at our universities. What kind of users we are going to cater? What are their research needs? Because the standards are kind of instruments. They provide us guidelines, they provide us certain steps to be followed under which we can really grow our libraries. Then the third point comes into the nature of access. If we have print resources, what kind of records we are maintaining to locate and identify the print resources? Also, what kind of electronic access we are going to provide? So, since we are the developing country, we love this tab, I think. We all love this tab for our country. So, we have to think in parallels. At one hand, we have crores of e-resources at our libraries. And at another hand, we have still maintenance for the print books. So, providing access to those kind of resources is another important point. Then comes the maintenance of everything. And how it is possible, that is the fourth point I'm going to say about the human resources for the library, the personnel. So all these library standards somehow relate to different kind of components of libraries, maybe in the form of library personnel, then the collection, then the user needs, the kind of future services we are going to provide, we are going to implement in our libraries. And definitely, the instrumentation provided by the library standards should be in our mind. Because that, as Neeraj also said earlier, and few other senior speakers told us, that awareness and promotion is very much important. As a student 25 years ago, I may not be aware. As student, maybe 40 years ago, Professor Shailendra Kumar could be aware of CDSIS. And today I am thinking about, okay, functional requirement of bibliographic records. Even today it is important because we are talking about digital scenario or interoperability of various things in our system. So all these things should be considered before understanding and implementing any library standard. And we cannot forget the risk management in libraries, which is always there in the terms of water, fire, or any other calamity, any other God thing. Okay, so that's all from my side.
Respected Professor Shalin sir, respected library professionals, and respected Rajesh sir, for giving me such an opportunity. Instantly, while sitting in this hall. So, I'm Dr. Garima Sharma. I'm working as a deputy librarian in NIT Delhi. And since last year, I'm working in NIT system. I joined initially NIT Uttarakhand as an assistant librarian. And now I'm a deputy librarian at NIT Delhi. So, this is the standards. Whatever I came across the standards today, it's very important, and I have gained a lot of knowledge today about these standards. Whatever we have read in our books, that is very limited, but with the experiences we learn more and more. So in brief, what I came to know from today's seminar is, like, for the libraries, budget is very important, money is very important for everyone. So requirements of standards for library and information activity, it is very much required for us because there is always a budget constraint in the libraries. So if there are standards, there are certain guidelines, so if we are planning a library building, we are procuring any new furniture or anything, so that will be based on certain standards. That standard will be It will ensure that safety, and it will provide a longevity to that building. Like our NIT Delhi, it is a termites prone land. So they are termites. So we are, our new campus is in construction phase. Library building will come up in the second phase. So currently we are running our library from administration block, and Now, when it came to the procurement of the furniture, then wooden furniture looks good and metal stacks, they are not so good for the ambience. So, we were thinking like how we can procure only the wooden stacks for our libraries, that so many termites are there. So, we designed a furniture with the help of the Jikin, which is helping us, the metal plus wooden furniture. So outer frame is wooden and internal is metal. So it looks good also. So, but I don't know whether it is based on some standard or not. We just provided our requirements to the consultants. They asked me what all you want, and I was not aware of any, like we have read the library building standard and all, but in today's environment, in digital environment, everything is changed. So what I feel is, the standardization, first of all, it provides the uniformity, it saves our money, it helps in planning the right and decision making, to make the right decision, and to ensure a longevity. And if the standards are developed, there are certain standards in all the libraries, so the similar group of person, if working in the same environment, so they come up with a different idea, so you can discuss the pros and cons of those things, and that can be updated from time to time. Like technology is there, technology is updated from time to time, and everything else becomes obsolete. So the standards ko hum update nahi karte hain time to time. Once the standard is developed and not updated, and how it will be updated, we all have the responsibility to work on it. We have to update that. So how we can update that, it will come from our experiences. Until and unless we will not work on it, we cannot share our experiences. So what all I understood is, practically we need to work upon it, we need to implement it in our library, then only this seminar like it's going to be a successful in future. So this is, I think, just a beginning, an initiative, and now it's the responsibility. Let's be 100 people, we have all the responsibility now to spread it to the 1000 people now. Like the Jio network na shuruaat hui thi free se aur kuch villages se, but now it's all over. So that's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So thank you very much once again for giving this opportunity. Although I've already shared my views on this topic, but again I would like to add some important aspect. I was discussing about three important things. One is adoption of ISO standards. So I think we need to identify the standards which are really useful for our libraries. We need to adopt those standards, although we are doing that. But I think some frequency should be more for the meetings of MST, so that we will be able to identify these standards and find out which are useful standards for the library people, and we need to adopt with few changes which are actually required, right? Second one is revision. From the very beginning, I was putting my views on that revision is very important. Otherwise, there is no question of having those standards, because in current scenario, current technological changes, it's not possible for the library, it's not feasible for the libraries to implement those standards, right? So keeping the feasibility in mind, I think we need to change the standards which are already in place. Third one is new areas. There are a number of new areas in which we need to have some standards, and I was when Dr. Rajesh Singh ji was presenting his views on electronic resources, it comes from my mind that why we cannot have a standard policy for acquisition of electronic resources. At least some guidelines should be there, right? Some guidelines should be there for subscription of electronic resources, or purchases of archives of electronic parts, or collection development policy is another important thing in which print and electronic collection both can come under that. So I think there should be some proper guidelines in the form of standards, and that can help to the librarians for getting the approvals at different levels, right? So we have some clear-cut guidelines in the form of standards. I think that can help in that. Another thing is when he was talking about some of the important terms related to license agreements, he discussed some of the things, but there are many more things which are involved in license agreement. And one important thing is, I would like to say here, the auto renewal, right? Sometimes we are signing the agreements without going through it, just going through the price and signing the agreements. But in case of electronic resources, the price as well as the terms conditions both are equally important. If they are giving us 95 or 99% discount and putting some important clause in the agreement, I think there is no question of having the 99% discount on the resource, right? Sometimes they are writing that auto renewal will be done if you are not providing the order within before 3 months. So some kind of agreement should be there, or if any model license agreement is there, I think that will help to the different libraries and libraries. Although ESS is working on that, but I think there should be proper guideline in that. Another thing is RFID part. Although they are already having they have already adopted one ISO standard for RFID, but I think we need to keep the changes keeping in view of the scenario or different kind of libraries in India. I think we need to make the changes on that, and also we need to keep the changes with respect to the softwares which are used in India. So these are some of the things, and I think some new the standards in new areas need to be developed in emerging areas, like we discussed about AI and all. So we need to keep all those things in mind. So for ensuring the good services for the users, ultimately our purpose is that. So all these things need to be done, keeping the focus on our user. User should be the focus for discussing or for developing any kind of standards. This is all about myself. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. As sir mentioned that I don't belong to your domain, my dear friends, all the esteemed guests and my dear friends. As I belong to history, I was just before this session, I was just seeing some references, and while going through some text, if I'm not wrong, it was 1884, New York State University adopted a statement of minimum requirement for proper library standards. And when I was just scrolling and I was searching through this some text, all of a sudden I recall the ancient university Nalanda. मुझे प्रश्न पड़ा कि नालंदा के 1 लाख से ज्यादा ग्रंथों के उस ग्रंथालय ने क्या स्टैंडर्ड ऑपरेटिव सिस्टम इस्तेमाल किए होंगे. This is a different story that it was plundered, it was the monks were killed by the Bakhtiar Khilji. लेकिन इसके पश्चात मुझे प्रश्न उठता है कि ये इस लाइब्रेरी ने, इस ग्रंथालय ने, फिर वो तक्षशिला हो, वो नालंदा हो, वो विक्रमपुरी हो, ओदंतपुरी हो, वो कामा, वो नीचे कांचीपुरम हो, इन इन विद्यापीठों ने, इन यूनिवर्सिटीज ने क्या स्टैंडर्ड्स, क्या स्टैंडर्ड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम होंगी, क्या स्टैंडर्ड्स होंगे उनके. और मुझे एक चीज की ओर मैं आपका ध्यान आकर्षित करना चाहता हूं, नालंदा के ग्रंथालय का जो नाम था उसका नाम था धर्मगुंज. बड़ा महत्वपूर्ण नाम है. द वर्ड गुंज इज साउंड एंड द वर्ड धर्म, द धर्म इज नॉट रिलीजन इन इंडिया. धर्म इज डिफरेंट एंड रिलीजन इज डिफरेंट. इफ आई कोट सम एग्जाम्पल, वॉट धर्म इज डिकोडेड बाय लॉर्ड बुद्ध, भगवान बुद्ध, ही सेज धारेति धर्म और धारेति धम्म. किसी बुढ़िया ने भगवान बुद्ध से पूछ लिया, तू धर्म की बड़ी व्याख्या करता है, मुझे तो समझ में नहीं आता, आसान शब्दों में मुझे धर्म बताओ. तो भगवान बुद्ध कहते हैं, सब पापस्य अकरणम कुशलस्य उपसंपदा सचित्त परियोद परम एतन बुद्धानुशासन. धर्म की व्याख्या. अष्टादश पुराणेषु व्यासस्य वचनं द्वयम् परोपकाराय पुण्याय पापाय परपीडनम, महर्षि व्यास की व्याख्या. और इस धर्म कुंज की जब मैं बात करता हूं और लाइब्रेरी साइंस पे आता हूं, तो मेरे बीच बैठे हम सभी का धर्म क्या है, खास करके लाइब्रेरी साइंस आने वाले सभी का धर्म क्या है, मुझे सर लगता है आप सभी लोग उस क्षेत्र में हैं, विश्व को, समाज को भद्र और सभ्य करने के प्रक्रिया में आप लोग लगे हैं, इसलिए मुझे लगता है कि आपका प्रथम धर्म है कृणवंतो विश्वमादि। मुझे तो लगता है भारत के सभी ग्रंथालयों का यह घोषवाक्य होना चाहिए कि कृणवंतो विश्वमार्यम, हम पूरे विश्व को समाज को सभ्य करने की पराकाष्ठा हम करते हैं, इसलिए कृणवंतो विश्वमार्यम ये हमारा धर्म है। आगे जाते हुए मैं एक चीज मैंने देखी आपके स्टैंडर्ड्स में, वो था परफॉर्मेंस इंडिकेटर। जब परफॉर्मेंस इंडिकेटर की बात आई तो एक वाक्य दिखा कि टू एनेबल यूजर्स टू डिस्कवर इंफॉर्मेशन इन ऑल फॉर्मेट इफेक्टिवली। वेरी सॉरी टू से, अनफॉर्चुनेटली सम नॉट सम बट मेनी कॉलेजेस आई हैव सीन द लाइब्रेरीज दैट सम स्पेसिफिक स्कॉलर्स एंड स्पेसिफिक थिंकर्स हैव बीन पुश्ड आउट ऑफ द सेल्फ शेल्फ। द रीजंस आई डोंट नो, बट वेन आई सर्च हियर जीबी महेंद्रे इट वॉज नॉट देयर, वेन आई सर्च छत्रपति शिवाजी हिस्ट्री इट वॉज नॉट देयर, वेन आई सर्च बीबी लाल इट वॉज नॉट देयर, आरसी मुजुमदार इट वॉज नॉट देयर। कई लोगों को हमने आउट ऑफ शेल्फ कर दिया है। मुझे लगता है यू पीपल आर गोइंग टू प्ले अ वेरी क्रूशियल रोल इन हैविंग द इंडिक परस्पेक्टिव स्कॉलर्स ऑल्सो। दिस इज द एरा दैट वी हैव स्टार्ट थिंकिंग, जो 20 साल पहले चाइना ने शुरू किया चाइल्ड लाइब्रेरीज के ऊपर काम करना। 20 साल पहले चाइना ने शुरू किया कि पूरे हॉवर्ड हो, स्टैनफोर्ड हो, ऑक्सफोर्ड हो, उन यूनिवर्सिटीज में जो जो नॉलेज सिस्टम है वो चाइना से ओरिजिनेटेड है, ये बताने की जो उसने शुरुआत की। शायद हम पीछे है लेकिन हमको इंडियन परस्पेक्टिव में सोचना पड़ेगा, देन वी कैन क्लेम दैट वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस, वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड ऑल काइंड ऑफ नॉलेज टू अवर यूजर्स। एंड द फाइनल थिंग दैट इज द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन दैट यू आर इन्वॉल्व विथ। डॉक्यूमेंटेशन ये ऐसी चीज है जिसमें आप लोग इन्वॉल्व है, और डॉक्यूमेंटेशन का महत्व क्या है मुझे आप लोगों को बताने की बिल्कुल जरूरत नहीं है। वी नो दैट 1796 वी नो फॉर द इट इज एडवर्ड जेनर दैट वी टॉक अबाउट द स्मॉल पॉक्स वैक्सीन। स्मॉल पॉक्स वैक्सीन इज रिलेटेड विद एडवर्ड जेनर, बट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स देयर इज अ डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, देयर इज अ डॉक्यूमेंटेड फैक्ट। इट इज 10th February 1731 प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर जे जेड हॉलवेल राइटिंग अ लेटर टू ब्रिटिश टू ब्रिटेन इन अ टू अ फिजिशियन एंड ही इज मेंशनिंग द स्मॉल पॉक्स इनोकुलेशन इन आवर कंट्री। दिस टाइप ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंटेशन वेदर वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट दिस इन अवर लाइब्रेरी एंड आई थिंक this is going to be our duty. There is a very small place in Adilabad district of Telangana, that is the Koma Samudram. My dear friends, Koma Samudram was known for the best quality producing iron in the world. Yahan se bane lohe ki jo talware hoti thi wo best quality ki mani jati thi duniya mein. We have documented facts, but that's why I am just here to incorporate that our Indian knowledge system and that idea, that attitude should be incorporated through our libraries. That's my submission, and thank you for calling, and thank you everyone for this wonderful event.
प्रशांत जी भाई साहब, आपका तो धन्यवाद सबसे पहले कि आपने अपने छोटे से वक्तव्य में लोगों में एक जोश भर दिया कि पुस्तकालय और पुस्तकालय में कार्य करने वाले लोगों की महत्ता कितनी है। उसके लिए आपको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। Yes, we need a standards, but at the same time we have the NIRF, we have a NAC, National Assessment Accreditation Council, National Institutional Ranking Framework. जैसा थोड़ी देर पहले मैंने कहा था कि last 24 years में I have never read about the standards as such as a curriculum. The BIS, the Government of India, should make a mandatory provisions. As far as the library is concerned, I am a college librarian, I am from Deshbandhu College. दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय के colleges की जो स्थिति है, जैसा कि भाई साहब ने कहा कि कुछ authors की किताबें जो हैं, लेखक किताबें shelf पर मिलेंगी नहीं, जो कि किसी कारण से वो ऐसा हुआ है। लेकिन वहां पर बुक शेल्फ का कंडीशन कैसा है, स्पेस खर्च कितना है, फर्नीचर की स्थिति किस प्रकार की है। वी हैव अ स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर बिल्डिंग, वी हैव अ स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर फर्नीचर्स, वी हैव द स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर रीडिंग एरिया, लेकिन हमारे पास कितना रीडिंग एरिया है, कितना चेयर्स है, हमारे पास कितना मैन पावर है। across the India, we have a different recruitment rules for appointing the library staff. But we do not have any universal policy for recruiting a library staff. तो मुझे लगता है कि सबसे पहले मैन पावर, क्योंकि who is going to provide the services? The library staff is going to provide the services. Who is assessing the need of the user? The library staff is assessing the need of the user. So BIS should make a standard for appointing the library professional across the India, universally. We have a technical institutions, we have academic institutions, we have a school libraries, we have a college libraries, but we have different rules and regulations. We have AICT for technical institutions, we have the UGC, but we have a different rules. So it make mandatory, make a uniform policy. अभी थोड़ी देर पहले शिवांगन ने कहा कि बजट, और अभी गरिमा ने भी कहा कि बजट. As far as the college library is concerned, I am the only college librarian in the panelist. There is a huge variation among the colleges as far as the budget is concerned. Head of the institution के पास library professional जाता है, librarian जाता है कि ये काम कराना है, पैसा नहीं है. कोई दूसरा विभाग जाता है, बहुत पैसा है, खर्च कर दीजिए. कहीं पर कटौती करनी है, कहां करनी है? पुस्तकालय में करनी है. टीचर अपॉइंट होता है, गेस्ट टीचर अपॉइंट होता है, वर्कलोड बनता है, गेस्ट टीचर आता है, एडहॉक टीचर आता है. ऐसा रहता है कॉलेज इज कंसर्न. लेकिन लाइब्रेरी स्टाफ में 20 लोगों का सेंक्शन पोजीशन है, आपके पास 6 लोग काम कर रहे हैं, वो चाहते हैं कि 4 से काम कर लो, अपॉइंट ही मत करो. सो देर शुड बी रेगुलर यूनिफॉर्म पॉलिसी एज फार एज द स्टैंडर्ड इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज द गाइडलाइन इज कंसर्न फॉर द रिक्रूटमेंट ऑफ द मैन पावर एंड द सेंक्शनिंग ऑफ द बजट. We are in 2024. If we are within a year, 2 years, within a coming years, we are able to make an a policy. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि अगर library standard policy या guidelines अगर आती है और हम लोग उसको implement करते हैं तो 2047 का जो स्वप्न है विकसित भारत का, वो हम उसको पूरा कर पाएंगे. धन्यवाद.
Thank you all the panelists. I started with a note that what are the sections and services where standards are required. I believe every aspect of the functioning of libraries needs some guidelines and standards. But with this panel of experts, we have come to know that revisions of the existing standards are essential, as well as the publicity of those standards are equally important, because if something is existing, take my case, I was not aware that there are standards for libraries. So if something is existing, that is not sufficient. Existence is not sufficient. Publicity is required. I do believe that there must be a standard on budgetary provisions for staff, for print resources and for e-resources. This is the need of the day. I do believe and agree with the learned panelist Dr. Prashant Arve. We have a very rich Indian knowledge system, and as a library professional, we also own responsibilities to promote the Indian knowledge system through the libraries, which has been neglected since a long time. And with this panel, I make a request that if we could also consider for putting some standards on Indian knowledge system or knowledge system of the libraries, where Indian knowledge system is made an important part, that will be a contribution from the library fraternity to the growth of India and to the vision of our Honorable Prime Minister of Viksit Bharat by 2047.